Warning. Censorship. Warning. Censorship.
Say no.
We have one of the best systems in the world that we can vote.
You're putting pastors
we
in
can
jail.
Change laws.
Like that's not the best in the world. Canada right now is a laughing stock of the world.
Putting pastor in jail.
You Calgary are right
police.
Now.
I'm doing my job
are,
by
sir.
Taking him.
No other jurisdiction is imprisoning pastors for breaking health orders.
Again, I'm not going to speak to that. Okay.
In Canada.
Okay.
It's only Alberta.
I would say continue the course that you're continuing on. Push further ahead. Push harder if you need to. And that's
how
all I can
How much harder
you
can we push here?
I don't know how far
Will
you've
you
gotten.
Will you arrest me and take me away
out.
From them too?
I have like, no reason to arrest you, right? So I'm going to leave it at that, okay? But I say just stay your course. If you feel that strongly about it, just stay the course, okay?
Did you hear Raquel Stevens, though? Did you hear her push back on that cop who said, well, stand up for what you believe in? And Raquel goes, and then what? You going to take me? Are you going to take the kids next? Like, that's what Tim's going to jail for. It's not bad enough that they seized his church property. They've grace life them completely.
Yep.
They seized the church property. Now they've taken Tim. And from what I understand, Tim had a bail hearing last night. And just like Pastor Coates, he cannot abide by those bail conditions. So he's going to stay in jail. And Raquel's got all those kids to take care of by herself. And those kids are traumatized. Traumatized. They've seen their dad arrested by the state twice. It's the worst thing I've seen in this pandemic. The absolute worst is the trauma that those kids and that family has been put through twice at the hands of Jason Kenney and the police in Calgary.
What a concept, eh, Sheila? And, you know, without further ado, why don't we go to the top story, I think. And I got to say, Sheila, and maybe this is a preamble warning, some of this content I found disturbing. I think when you see children crying as their father is taken away in a police cruiser, not for any kind of real crime like assault or murder or rape or what have
yep.
you, but for preaching the gospel, man, I don't know what these Calgary police are made of that they can carry out this little jihad when they go about arresting preachers. But of course, turn a blind eye to the elite politicians at the what's it called, the Sky Palace.
Mm-hmm.
You know, wow, what a fitting name, eh? A palace yeah. up in the sky. Does it get any more visual than that? In any event, folks, like I said, it's a little cringy and disturbing when you see this video. And thankfully, our man Adam was on the scene to record it, because you're not going to see it on any of the other mainstream news platforms, as Sheila and I discussed before. So here is the latest chapter in the saga of Pastor Tim.
Basically, these are the laws that everyone in Canada basically has agreed to abide by. Right?
Yeah, Jason Kenney can have his dinner up in the Sky Palace, and no one's coming to his house to take him to jail.
You know what? It's like I said, it has nothing to do with that. I'm dealing with this, right? Yeah.
This is incredible. It's incredible. You know, they can have their gathering in the Sky Palace, and yet a pastor who gathers for church outside is being arrested.
Yeah.
You know, because the rules certainly don't apply to everyone equally, and they're not enforced to everyone equally. Like, why is it pastors that keep getting arrested for this? And if you have parents who go to church, or you understand that our Lord Jesus Christ actually commands us to gather and to meet.
And he also told us wherever two or three are gathered, there he is in the midst of us. So we don't need a huge gathering.
Well, if you want to talk about that
but
passage
in
Matthew
18. No, we're not talking about that. Right now, we're just doing our job, okay? So, and if you hadn't basically broken the order or the rules that are set out right now, I wouldn't be here, right? Do I want to be here? No. Right?
Yes, and when laws are unjust, then it's incumbent upon those who are righteous
to stand up
and say no.
We have one of the best systems in the world that we can vote.
You're putting pastors
in
jail.
We can change laws.
Like, that's not the best system in the world. Canada right now is a laughing stock of the world.
Who's putting pastor in jail?
You Calgary are
police.
Right now.
I'm doing my job
are,
by
sir.
Taking him, but then again,
and you've sworn an oath to uphold the
Constitution.
I
arrest people for theft. I arrest people whenever they break the law.
Yes,
right?
This is the
rule and the law in the land right now. So I have to arrest your husband. When I arrest someone for theft, I don't want to arrest that person and deal with them. But if they break a law that I'm basically sworn to uphold, I have to arrest him.
Have so you what? So every the actions. That's ever broken these laws?
No, but it's have that's, you that's yourself the same. That's ever the same. Broken yes. I've broken rules.
You have too?
Of course I have.
And so why are you not under threat of arrest right now?
Okay.
The sooner that we go, the sooner you get back to your family.
Yeah. Well, no.
He's already with us.
Yeah.
But yes, but he has to go.
The sooner you leave, yes. The sooner you
guys,
with
guys come here. Come get me. Come me out here.
No other jurisdiction is imprisoning pastors for breaking health orders.
Again, I'm not going to speak to that, okay?
In Canada,
okay.
It's only Alberta.
I would say continue the course that you're continuing on. Push further ahead. Push harder if you need to. And that's all I can tell you.
How much harder can we push here?
I don't know how far
you've
gotten.
Will you arrest me and take me away from them too?
I have no reason to arrest you, right? So I'm going to leave it at that, okay? But I say just stay your course. If you feel that strongly about it, just stay the course, okay?
Can you guys share maybe why Jason Kenney gets a free pass and you're arresting pastors across the province? Any comment, any emotion for this family whatsoever? No, you're just going to drive off just like that. Is this why you became a police officer?
No, sir, I did not. Have a good day.
Don't block the car, though, so they don't get hit.
My daddy.
Bye, guys. Okay. Okay. We're gonna move. Okay.
Okay.
Not too close. Not too close.
Okay, guys, step back, please.
Bye, daddy.
I love you very much. Okay. Church.
Wow, that puts a lump in my throat, Sheila. I mean, there's so much to unpack there. You know, I couldn't help but notice on those Calgary police SUVs, I guess it's the slogan of the Calgary police, vigilance, courage, pride. I don't know if that's the traditional definition of pride or they've just got pride there for pride, Gay Pride Month right now. Who knows? But, you know, I'll tell you, Ezra had a fantastic monologue yesterday where he named Staff Sergeant McLean the worst cop in Canada. He's with the Peterborough Police Service in regard to my personal situation. Maybe Ezra jumped the gun. Maybe, yeah. I don't have the name of that, you know, the bald police officer, the guy in charge. Let's just call him Sergeant Stadanko, for lack of a better term. But the condescending way he was treating this pastor. And why don't we get an answer for the pastor asked it, Adam asked it. Why does the pastor get hauled away? I guess they spared him handcuffs, unlike Maxime Bernier in Manitoba on Friday. So thank goodness for little miracles. But why don't we get an answer to that question? Why him and why not the head honcho in charge, Jason Kenney, and all his elite pals at the Sky Palace? Why is that, oops, sorry guys, we'll try harder next time? That is just shameful. And again, Sheila, it comes down to back when Jason Kenney was an MP and he was all about religious freedom the world over. And look what's happening in Alberta. Could you ever have dreamed this?
David, I hope those images of Tim's kids reaching into that cop car to hold their dad's hand. I hope that that is a campaign ad against Jason Kenney. Mm-hmm. I'm furious. I had to stop several times when I was watching the video last night just to get through it. I hope that that is put on a billboard truck and it is driven around every single Jason Kenney campaign event forever. I hope those images hang like a millstone around his neck forever. I wonder if Jason Kenney can hear the shrieking and sobbing of Tim and Raquel's frightened children all the way up there in Sky Palace. And boy, you know, I get it. I get it now. You've got to put down a lot of Jameson to be able to sleep at night. when you're the man responsible for what happened to Tim yesterday. And did you preface Tim with those cops? He's praying with his children. He's telling them, don't be angry. Mm-hmm. Don't be angry. And those cops are blaming Tim for what they have to go through, how hard it is on them. The woman cop says, I know this is frustrating for me too. You're telling this to Raquel Stevens as she's holding her brand new baby, crying kids all around. You're taking her husband away for what? What's his crime? Holding church. And the other cop says, your husband's actions, I wrote it down as he was saying it, your husband's actions have put me in this position.
Yes.
That man is the worst cop in Canada. And as he was fighting with Tim over scripture, by the way, I don't want a cop that's going to cite scripture. Yeah. I really don't. Because...
The render onto Caesar line you're referring to here, right?
Yeah.
Unbelievable. First,
let's go back a little because it reminded me of something from The Merchant of Venice. Because that phrase, and I brought it up as he was saying it because I want to get it right. The devil can cite scripture for his purpose. An evil soul producing holy witness is like a villain with a smiling cheek, a goodly apple rotten at the heart. Oh, what a goodly outside falsehood hath. And that's what it reminded me of. You know, when he is saying to Tim Stevens, a pastor, and again, this brings me back to do whatever you want to do in your church. I don't care. And I don't want the state to care. And I especially don't want officers of the state telling somebody else what they should be doing in their church, which is exactly what this cop did when he quoted Mark 12:17. Render unto Caesar that which is Caesar's. There, that's the preface there. That which is Caesar's. The next part of that is render unto God that which is God's. As in, the church belongs to God and not the state. Do what you need to do for the state, but do not suck things into the state that don't belong to the state. I cannot get over the pathetic attempts of that Roman soldier, I'll call him, to twist scripture. There are those of us who believe in separation of church and state, like me, as in, I don't want the church molested by the state. And I don't want to hear a weak theological argument from a cop who doesn't have any comprehension of what's going on. And finally, for context, do you know how many new coronavirus cases were diagnosed in Alberta yesterday? 115 in a province of 4.5 million. Tim Stevens is not only being arrested under an order that doesn't apply to him at all, but secondarily for a health emergency that no longer exists. Shame. Shame on everybody involved here. It's one of the worst things I've ever seen.
It is shameful. And two things, Sheila. One is the mixed messages. Those cops were saying, well, if you hadn't put us in this predicament, we wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be arresting you. And then the female officer says to Tim Stevens' wife, stay the course. Basically, fight for what you believe in. But wait a minute. Fighting for what I believe in brings you to my front door and gets my husband hauled away in a police SUV. What kind of garbage is that? Stay the course. She's basically saying, yeah, break the law and we'll be back here again. And the other thing, the law, this law that they're saying we are so beholden to uphold, and you know, and if you don't like it, well, you know, there's a change of government at a future date, which in Alberta's case is 2 years, I believe, before there's another provincial election. Wait a minute. As Ezra has pointed out on several occasions too, Sheila, a lot of this so-called law has basically been written by unaccountable, unelected health bureaucrats. And yep. I refuse to call them top doctors like the mainstream media does. No. Most of these cats haven't practiced medicine in decades if they practice it at all. So it's not so much law, it's rules that are being put in place by people who are never elected, who are never meant to write our laws. And I'm telling you, Sheila, whenever this pandemic ends, there's going to be a day of reckoning. We have to ensure we never end up in this situation again, where the Cruella de Villas of the world become drunk with power and destroy people's lives without any kind of empathy whatsoever. Anyways, that's what I have to say.
Did you hear Raquel Stevens, though? did you hear her push back on that cop who said, well, stand up for what you believe in? And Raquel goes, and then what? You gonna take me? Are you gonna take the kids next? Like, that's what Tim's going to jail for. It's not bad enough that they seized his church property. They've grace life them completely. Yep. They seized the church property. Now they've taken Tim. And from what I understand, Tim had a bail hearing last night. And just like Pastor Coates, he cannot abide by those bail conditions. So he's going to stay in jail. And Raquel's got all those kids to take care of by herself. And those kids are traumatized. Traumatized. They've seen their dad arrested by the state twice. It's the worst thing I've seen in this pandemic. The absolute worst is the trauma that those kids and that family has been put through twice at the hands of Jason Kenney and the police in Calgary.
And one other thing I want to say, Sheila, is that, you know, Pastor Tim Stevens, what a class act. I mean, he could have been, you know, well, it wouldn't be in him to drop an F-bomb, but I mean,
no.
As a viewer, you get so enraged watching this, and I don't want to say what I was muttering while I was watching it, but he is calm, cool, collected. He's all about love. He's hugging his family. He's not even in the face of these police officers, and he has every right to be. I just want to say what an incredible class act. And I hope your wish comes true. I hope when the election comes along, those images resurface to remind people that Premier Kenney was behind this.
Yeah. I mean, I should be taking Pastor Tim's advice when he said, don't be angry, because I'm furious. Like, my blood is boiling.
Yeah.
But I guess it's better to be mad than to be just a wreck because of what I've just witnessed the state put that family through. And who knows when Tim's going to get out? Who knows when they end it? I mean, we're moving into stage 3 here in Alberta,
yep,
where there's going to be no masks and no restrictions. You're going to keep this guy in jail for what? Till when? After stage 3? Till we're at COVID zero? What is it going to take for Tim to be allowed to do what he is called by God to do? And again, no coronaviruses, no cases linked to his church, not a one. So where do the two things meet? How does the enforcement of these regulations meet the threat that Tim is putting the community in?
And again, the Sky Palace incident, we have video footage of that. We have the proof in the pudding. What, that's a nothing burger? I mean, it's now become a joke that Premier Kenney is leading by example. And as to the jail matter, Sheila, was it 35 days that Pastor Coates spent in that horrific Edmonton maximum security penitentiary? Is this what Pastor Tim is in for too? That is just shameful.
Well, and he'll likely be in COVID isolation when he comes in. So he'll, in effect, solitary confinement. Again, it's my understanding that he won't accept the conditions of his bail. So he'll just remain in there until somebody figures out what to do with him, just like with Pastor Coates. And his congregation is driven completely underground. So we have at least 2 underground congregations here in Alberta, 4 pastors arrested, and 2 of them have served some pretty serious jail time. I mean, it sounds like Tim's going to be in there for a long time. So, I mean, what an absolute disgrace. What an absolute disgrace that this is the province of strong and free. This is led by Jason Kenney, the premier who was the advocate for religious freedom around the world. How does he justify what he did to that family last night? Because I don't care if it was the Calgary cops and the worst cop in Canada, that bald cop, the absolute worst. I don't care if it's them. They're being enabled by the decision makers. Yep. And if Jason Kenney isn't making the decisions, he's allowing somebody else to make the decisions. Our unelected health bureaucrats, the buck stops with him. What happened to Tim Stevens' family stops with Jason Kenney. And he should be absolutely ashamed of himself. I don't know how he sleeps at night. I have no idea.
And on that note too, Sheila, those cops, when they go home to their families and they take off their uniforms and they take their weapons away and just become Joe and Jane citizen, do they go you know what, honey, I helped save the province from more COVID positive cases. I got that guy, that Pastor Tim, out of his home. He's now in the cooler. Or do they say to their family, I can't believe what I have to do as a cop. You know, I signed up to put away the bad guys, and now look what they're making me do. I would love to be a fly on the wall of those police officers' homes and find out what they really think when the cameras aren't rolling about what they are doing these days, Sheila.
Constable Terrible Cop in Calgary there, he thinks that he's doing the absolute Lord's work. I really do. I think that he thinks that I'm making sure those Christians render unto Caesar that which is Caesar's.
Jeez.
I really do. Like, he feels like he's the victim here. Look what your husband is making me do because he broke the law. Your husband is making me feel this way. Not my conscience, your husband.
Yep.
That cop, I don't think he has any sort of moral struggles at all. I think that he is completely convinced that he's perfectly okay and he's doing the right thing. I'm not so sure about that female cop. I think Adam pushed her on that. And, you know, that's another thing. Adam was there with this family as it happened. I mean, it's got to be tough on Adam and Kian too, K2, to have been there to bear witness to all of this. I mean, Adam's got little kids at home too. But you don't, Adam usually takes a kind of a hands-off approach with the cops, and that's, he's sort of following the rules of engagement of the pastors that he's covering, right? Like, they don't want you there fighting with the cops. Just whatever the cops do, please record it, but you're not the story, right? But Adam pushed back on that one lady cop, and she admitted that this is not what I signed up to do.
Yeah.
And well, then why are you doing it?
And, you know, Sheila, before we get to the chats on this, Adam and K2 were kind of lucky in a way that this didn't happen in Hamilton or Peterborough, because they could have been ticketed or arrested. Lack of social distancing, not wearing a mask. There was nothing to laugh about, but if they had laughed, evidently that's offside in Peterborough, too. We'll get to that in a few seconds, folks. So, in a way, they're lucky. They certainly had room in those other SUVs parked out. By the way, why such a display of force? They know this isn't a crack den in Calgary that they're going into with illegal handguns. They know this is a gentle, peace-loving pastor, a true gentleman, and they had to bring that kind of show of force? What the?
It's intimidation. It's the same reason they bring the riot squad to Pastor Art. It's the same reason they took him down like he was a terrorist.
Yep.
On the street. I mean, you look at how they are treating this cop versus the, like, red carpet rollout they got for Omar Khadr, or treating these pastors versus the, like, red carpet rollout that Omar Khadr gets, right? Like, same province. One's a convicted Al-Qaeda terrorist, and the other ones just want to be obedient to God. It's, I mean, I just, I can't get over how bad that cop is. Yes, the cop who is offended that you chuckled and shook hands and did like normal human things, he's bad.
Yeah.
But I think that this cop in Calgary, and I'm dying to know his name, I hope you're watching, you are the worst cop in Canada, the most revolting, stomach-turning cop in this entire country. I hope you know that.
And given that you've, according to Sheila Gunn-Reed's estimation, you've bumped off Staff Sergeant McLean at the Peterborough Police Service. Wow, that's saying a mouthful. Jeez.
Trying to victim blame father he's snatching away from his family as he's doing it and making himself the victim and citing scripture to justify the arrest of the Christian pastor in front of his family. I don't know. I don't know if that can be topped.
And, you know, that seems to be a bit of a trend emerging, right? Our beloved colleague Tamara Ugolini out in Coburg, she had a piece several weeks ago, Sheila, remember, where the Coburg Police Service was complaining about the stress of handing out all these anti-lockdown tickets. And I can't remember the name of the Coburg police chief, a tall, bearded individual. All you remember is his gender pronouns, he, him.
Every time.
So chief he, him was saying, oh, look at us, look, it's so tough, it's so hard. Can you believe it?
Yeah, I can. I can believe that a cop like that would be concerned about the how hard it is on his members to go around arresting law-abiding people. Yeah. And again, turning the cops into the victims here. I'm pro-cop, but boy, these bad apples, they really can turn the tide for an entire police service. Oh, yeah. And it's going to take a very long time for police services to repair the reputations that they have allowed to be damaged so greatly by the bad apples in their midst.
100%, Sheila. And the worst thing about it is it doesn't have to be this way. There is no health crisis by having church services. There is no science behind this. Please spare us. We're just following the rules while you give a pass again to Premier Kenny and his friends for up in the Sky Palace whining and dining. So, you know, please. But anyways, I think we have some chats, do we not?
Yes. By the way, speaking of another politician that deserves those images of Tim Stevens crying children on a Jumbotron truck driving around his constituency office, Tyler Shandro, the health minister. You're in charge of AHS. You did nothing. Even if they went rogue, sure they did. But even if you want to claim that they went rogue and got this order that now they're using to go around and lock up pastors, you're in charge of AHS.
Yep.
Have them go before a judge and have that order tossed out. You haven't. You've seen pastor after pastor get arrested, and you're perfectly fine with it. We need to put this on a Jumbotron and drive it around Shandro's office. If he's going to the grocery store, I want a Jumbotron following him like a jaguar hunts a gazelle, so that those images follow him forever.
I love that idea, Sheila, and you got the clout around here to make it happen. I can say that.
Try not to abuse it. Anyways, let's for me being absolutely off the rev limiter, let's get to some of these chats. What you just saw there is a clip from our Rebel News daily live stream show. It's fun, it's fast, and it's completely unscripted, so you never really know what you're going to get. Just go to rebelnews.com/livestream.